Hey guys, so in the first video we learned what a closure is. It's a combination of function and its left to environment, which is So a closure is a combination of a function and its lexical environment, which is all the variables declared outside the inner function and within the outermost function. Okay. So we saw this example, and here we have this function, outermost function, and this inner function. So we have these variables which can be accessed within this function. Now, for example, let me run the code. Okay, so we got these variables, right? So we are calling this function func1, and then the execution of func1 finishes, and then we call this result, meaning we are calling the inner function. So we have access to these variables which are outside of this inner function, and naturally what should happen is that these variables should be garbage collected. So what actually happens that when a function starts execution and when it finishes, when the control comes to this line, and then all the variables, all the stuff declared inside the function are garbage collected. Stuff inside a function gets garbage collected, but in case of inner function which needs these variables still has them. So the stuff inside a function gets garbage collected, but in case of closure, the inner function which needs these variables still has access to them. So when this function is returned, then we call this function func1, outermost function, and it's returning a function, this one func2. So when this function is returned, it also returns all the variables which are outside of it, which are not part of this function. So this is a point to note, right? These stuff which is not inside this function, and the these do not belong to this one, this func2, they still get returned along with func2 over here in result. So when we call result, when we call function 2 func2, we have the access to all the stuff outside of it. So hence we are able to print 10 to 30 and hello. Right, so now let's move on to a more complex closure. So we can create a function, my outermost function. Over here we can create another function, my outer function. Inside it, let's create another one, inner func. Let's name it properly. So we have this variable over here, let name equal to John. Okay, and inside this function we are accessing this variable name. All right, and over here we're calling inner function, and here we're returning the outer function, return outer function. All right, so this is the outermost function, and we have this variable which belongs to this function only, and then we have another function within it and another one, right? So the innermost function is trying to access the variable name which is not part of this, and which isn't part of this function either, so it has to go all the way up to the parent, right? So what closure does is that first it will try to find name inside this function, so it can't find it, right? So it will go one level up. It will try to find the function, find the name over here, it can't find it, so it will go one level up, right? So we have name over here, so it will return name, it will console log name. So this way, this is called scope chaining, right? So what's happening over here is scope chaining. Let result true equal to, I can call my outermost function and it returns this function, and I can call this one over here. I can see the output. Okay, I get John, right? So it's called scope chaining. Which doesn't belong, which belongs to the outer function and goes all the way to the top. So that's pretty much it. I hope you got the concept of closure very well.